Claude 2 was released by Anthropic just a few weeks ago and is already making rounds as the latest ChatGPT competitor. But does it actually live up to the hype? Let's figure it out. I was able to compile some publicly available info and create this table where we can compare Claude 2 to its predecessor Claude 1 as well as to GPT-4. And the first thing that stands out here is the context window. So Claude 2 has a huge context window of 100,000 tokens. It's 10 times more than its predecessor and 3 times more than what GPT-4 has. And with 100,000 tokens, we can fit around a 10-page document in this prompt, which allows us to do analysis on big documents without requiring a vector database. I've also included results on how these models perform on the US bar exam. As you can see, they're pretty much up to par with Claude 2, coming ahead by just a few points. We also have results on how they perform on the Codex Human Evolved dataset. This tests how they understand and generate computer code. And as you can see, Claude 2 trumps both Claude 1 and GPT-4 in this dataset. Lastly, you could have the biggest and greatest AI model in the world, but if it is too expensive to run, its use cases in business are limited. As we can see, Claude 1 and Claude 2 are much cheaper to run than GPT-4. This is the completion cost per 1 million tokens. They're around 4 times less expensive than GPT. Now that we've seen the test results, one note that I do want to leave here is that these are results published by Anthropic, which is the team behind Claude 2. And while they are impressive, they don't give us the full picture on how this AI model is going to perform on real-world use cases. So let's go and test it. So here we are at the Anthropic website, which I'll also have linked in the video description. And much like OpenAI, they are offering a free beta of Claude for free. Unfortunately, this beta is currently only available for residents of the US or the UK, but it's very easy to get around this by registering your account with a VPN. So if you use a VPN in the US or in the UK, you'll be able to access this beta no matter where you are in the world. They also offer an API, so you're able to build applications on top of Claude. And unfortunately, this is not yet available to the public. You need to submit this form in order to get access, and they're not giving access to everyone. What I'm hearing right now is that they are prioritizing enterprise customers. So once you create your account and log in, you will land on this page, which is pretty similar to the ChatGPT page. They have a section where you can check out your previous conversations with the AI, and they also have an input box to start a new conversation. So let's start with something simple and just greet the AI model with a hey. Let's see what we get back. Pretty quickly, hello, how can I help you today? As you can see, it has been trained to act as an assistant. Let's give it something harder now. It's my first day at my job at Accenture and I'm feeling overwhelmed. How do I cope with these emotions? Let's see what we get back. And it pretty quickly starts generating the answer. Starting a new job can definitely be overwhelming. Here are some tips that may help. And then it lists some tips. And I would say this is a pretty good response, much like what a human would write. And I guess that these points are actually pretty actionable as well. Now let's try something different. I'm going to give it this prompt. If a tree falls in the forest and no one is around to hear it, does it make a sound? Explain your answer from both a philosophical and a scientific perspective. Let's see what we get. As you can see, it's pretty fast in generating text, much faster than GPT-4. And as we can see, it gives us both the philosophical and also the scientific perspective and a summary at the end. So I would say it's pretty good at responding to this. Another thing that I do want to try is giving a prompt that requires Claude to do some reasoning. So this is a book reading contest with 3 participants, and let's see what we get. So it breaks down the task and it gets the right results. So Clara has read the most pages, and feel free to pause this video and check out both the prompt and the completion to see what exactly is happening. But the result is correct from Claude. Another thing that stands out about Claude is that you are able to upload PDFs alongside your prompt. So I have uploaded one of my bank statements here, and we can ask Claude, what is this PDF about? And it will go ahead and analyze the PDF. It already gave a very relevant title, but let's see the completion. So it gives all sorts of details about the document. And I may have to blur some of the details here. But the result that I'm seeing is very, very good, and it matches what's inside the PDF. And you're also able to upload multiple PDFs to one prompt, so you're able to do cross-referencing with the documents that you have on Claude. One last note that I want to give is that Claude 2 has been trained on newer data than GPT. So if we ask it a question like, when did Queen Elizabeth die? Let's see what we get. She passed away on September 8th, 2022. Now, if we go ahead and ask the same question to GPT-3, we're going to get something different. So GPT-3 still thinks that Queen Elizabeth is alive. That was all for Claude, a very new and exciting AI model. Now, if you're looking for someone to help you deploy or train a custom AI model or develop your AI app, make sure to use the link in the video description and book a one-on-one call with me. I look forward to talking to you, and thank you for watching the video.